Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Venkatesh. I represent a company called AgriLife. We are a research-based organization based in Hyderabad, India. I'm associated with sustainable agriculture for the last 25 years as a manufacturer, as a business owner, and a farmer. Our main business is R&D. We work closely with companies like Copert, Biological Systems Holland, we have a joint venture company in India. The topic I'm going to make today is basically on a new technology for disinfection. We are here in Abu Dhabi, Middle East. Lot of emphasis is on the greenhouses and on irrigation, sprinklers, high-tech agriculture. You now see in high-tech agriculture, especially in polyhouses, greenhouses, soil pathogens become a very, very big problem. Huge amount of hydrogen peroxide and many, many toxic, hazardous disinfectants are used by farmers. They're carcinogenic, hazardous, but then unfortunately, they're also expensive. What we have done by research is how we take the ancient knowledge and blend it with most modern science of nanotechnology and offer safer, useful, effective, efficient solution for disinfection. The first concept of this, idea, the concept of nanotechnology, is as old as 1957. And a physicist brought the concept. The word nanotechnology was coined by Professor Noria in 1974. So it's not a very old technology. It's a fairly new technology. Reducing a particle size is basically science. If we do it by chemistry method, it's called reduction chemistry. There are many materials which I will not go into details of it. What exactly is the product I'm presenting? The technology is called Somguard. Silcop is silver as copper. What basically we do, silver is broken down into particle size less than 100 nanometer. The concentration of product is about 100 ppm. That means 0.1 milligram or 0.1 gram per liter of product. 0.1 gram per liter of product. This silver, after we reduce the size, is encapsulated by a biopolymer. The biopolymer is based on ketosan, which you know is a good biostimulant. It's a fungistatic action. Silver at a particle size less than 100 nanometer, encapsulated by a biopolymer. Similarly, 100 ppm copper, each particle less than 100 ppm and then a nanometer, is again encapsulated by the biopolymer. Now here the medium of dispersion is water. You would have heard a lot of silver in the market with hydrogen peroxide. This technology does not contain hydrogen peroxide. That's the first best part of the technology. Number two, because it is encapsulated by a biopolymer, it does not get oxidized when you spray on the plant or spray on the ground. It does not get oxidized. Therefore, the element of silver is maintained for the full effectiveness. And you know, silver has a lot of benefits of bleaching effect, cleanser, antiseptic. And this only product along with gold. Gold and silver are called noble metals. They have biocidal action. Before the virus enters the plant system, it is inanimate, no life of the protein. Gold and silver have ability to cause a sort of cold injury. We call it as attenuation and inactivate virus before entering plant system. Therefore, it is not only a disinfectant against fungus or bacteria, also against virus. How is it different? As I explained briefly, this conventional silvers available in market, all of them come with hydrogen peroxide. which is subjected to fire, explosion. The smoke oxidizes. Hydrogen peroxide is harmful if swallowed and causes severe skin burns. And the Songguard, which is formulated by the reduced silver and copper nanoparticles, using green chemistry, is eco-friendly product. Is non-toxic, biodegradable, and a very multifunctional product. Still complements silver copper.
How about that? We water.
What are the typical validation? Any grower would like to know. How do I know it works? The story is good.
Okay, no me gusta tanto.
The easiest thing is the basic
microbiology
lab. Any remote corner of India has a blood testing laboratory.
Basic lab.
Even a basic microbe laboratory can test the product.
So, okay.
We do in vitro studies, of this so-called sigma, gram-positive bacteria and gram-negative bacteria. The product simple, they have any problem or much details. We use normally USDA protocol. The dose recommended for product is about 5 ml to 10 ml per liter of water, soil disinfection. You know, soil is fusarium kind of severe wilt causing pathogens. And if this particular product, if you dilute in water at 2.5 ml, 5 ml per liter, and apply the water to soil, the disinfection would be medium. Look at the results which we get. Gram-positive bacteria, the protocol I explained to you. We just take the bacteria, inoculate it basically on the plate. And this is a test result at about 60 minutes after treating with the gram-positive bacteria. You can see in 60 minutes, less than 1 hour time, the colonies virtually from large number has come down to 2 colonies, and after about 60 minutes, 1 hour, you have almost nil colony in this particular treatment, which is done by silver and copper nanoparticle. What's the result? After 20 hours incubation, we have very few colonies and virtually no colony at all after 7 hours of exposure. Let's see what happens with gram-negative bacteria. You know, many gram-negative bacteria are highly pathogenic in soil and very difficult to control. And the same treatment is done at 5 ml of product, 5 ml of product per liter of water. We just put few microliters, and 60 minutes later, you are seeing the colonies are dead, plate is clean, and the same thing when you look at it after 60 minutes, you have zero colony by this nano silver plus nano copper treated plate. Results, you are seeing it in 20 hours from now, after treatment, there is no colony of the gram-negative bacteria. There is another very interesting study by USDA protocol where soil pathogens like fusarium to be tested. We take soil, autoclave it 3 times, make this trial complete, and then inoculate with the pathogen or the organism. Then treat the product. The test product is sold at nano silver cell copier. And when we do it, the sterile soil is inoculated with the pathogen, and then we apply the product. You can see the soil. At 10 ml per liter, we have applied the product. 10 ml product per liter of water. And in 60 minutes of sampling, you find a serious reduction in the count of bacteria. This is amazing. After about 1 week later, 1 week after application, the kind of colonies you find in control is this. And this is the control, the zero colony in the root zone or in the plate. This is how the product is basically validated. We do not need this kind of amazing results in field condition. In field, we have a lot of bacteria to work with. So the conclusion is the so-called SilCop is silver plus copper, nanotechnology product, less than 100 micron, 100 ppm each, is found to be broad spectrum natural disinfectant. A against all the pathogenic microbes like fungi, bacteria, and virus. One request we make to grower, after you disinfect the soil, immediately after 4 or 5 days, please re-inoculate with good bacteria. This is called disinfection. Next step is recolonization. So always a twin-edged weapon. Disinfection followed by recolonization with probiotic organisms. A lot of good bacteria we make. Our stall is A5, A5 AgriLife. You're most welcome for talking three more details with us. We can provide you more details. And Yasin is here, my friend from Cobert organization. Yasin, hello, please. He's here. Cobert has a stand here. Cobert offers the technology to worldwide farmers by brand name Go Clean. The green chemistry, a nice brand name Go Clean. I wish all the growers to take benefit of the new technology and have a good, more sustainable agriculture. Thank you very much. Allows 3-4 kilograms of that, and you're talking of 2 kilograms of copper, metallic copper, going to soil. 30 years it's going, 60-70 kilograms the copper mine. Compared to that, you're 0.1 gram per liter, goes to about 4,000 square meter. 10 years, 15 years, 100 years you use, it doesn't equal to 1 year application of copper. Number two, silver at that dosage, after disinfecting and causing cold injury, is not effective for next season or next cycle for killing the pathogen.
Is there any test done to show whether the copper or silver has been leached away after a year or so?
They do not leach away because of nano nature. Once the polymer ring breaks down, they form a salt. So in some form of the salt, they will remain on each other. They won't remain in the elemental form. Thank you. Yes.
It's good for bacteria. What about fungus also? It's good to get fungus.
Fungus, molds, algae. We have test reports. I can show you the cooling towers, big storage, water tank, farm ponds in the farm, where the algae is a major problem. So we just applied for that for farm ponds, cooling towers, water storage tanks. So algae and fungi also are equally controlled by this. And the last test we saw, the soil, is Fusarium fungus.
In case of high infestation of Fusarium, what's the dosage range that you should use per hectare and drip irrigation?
We assume 100 ppm of product, silver plus copper, 100 ppm each. At a high incidence of Fusarium, 10 ml of water, that's a 10 ml of product per liter of water. You need about 5 liters of product, 500 liters of water per hectare. That means 2.5 liter to maximum 5 liter per hectare. It is not more than 5 liter per hectare, the worst situation, the highest. One application for seasonal crops. For trees, we recommend one in the spring, one in the autumn, until the disease is there. Stop using it while the disease is not there. And please use the beneficial microbes after 1 week of application. that is a shock treatment product. We must bring back life to soil by doing good bacteria. Yes, sir.
Thank you very much for your presentation. I have one question. Is there some infusion on the pH of soil or the quantity of organic matter in the soil in the activity of this
disinfection technology bacillus is not affected by pH factor of soil, is not affected by organic matter, organic carbon. So irrespective of pH of organic carbon, you are free to use the product. Thank you very much. I have to go step over my time. Thank you, over back to the organization. Thank you very much for your patience here.